Hey, Faith Alliance Church, Pastor John here, coming to you with some exciting news about reopening, some news that I'm very excited about. Recording down here in our basement studio, kind of where we started things when this pandemic hit and where we sprung from a couple weeks ago, but wanted to talk to you from here just to say that we are not only talking about and not only praying about, but actually planning for and communicating about reopening. We're planning on reopening our services to live services. That means people coming into the building to be the church in the building starting May 31st. We're going to be offering two services, one at 9, one at 11, and we're going to be capping those services at 100 people each. Now that should give enough room for everyone to be a part, who wants to be a part, and we're going to ask that you register for those services, and we're going to send out a registration next week so that you just have to click a link and let us know how many people are coming in your party, and then you can join us on the 31st in our service. And again, because there's plenty of room and enough space based on the state's reopening policies sent to us on Monday the 18th, we're glad to be able to create enough space for everyone to meet. And that is thrilling. It's thrilling for us to be together. It's thrilling for us to reopen. And we're going to do it in a safe and secure way. And so we're going to ask that you wear a mask. We're going to require that you bring a mask. We're going to ask that you keep socially distant, 6 feet apart from one another that aren't a part of your immediate family. We're going to ask that after service is done, we'll have to dismiss you, and then you'll have to be on your way, and you can meet and talk and discuss things in the parking lot, but we're going to have to in order to make sure that we create a clean and safe environment, clean between services. And so we'll have masks available for you. We ask that you bring them, but we have them here. We'll have some ways to sanitize. We'll ask that you wash hands, of course, all the things that hundreds of people have been asking you to do the last couple of months anyway. Nothing really new in that department except for as we reopen. We just want to make sure that we're covering our bases and communicating all the things that we need to communicate. We'll also ask if you're part of a vulnerable population or if you feel like you have symptoms of COVID-19 or are feeling kind of under the weather, that you stay home. Don't worry, we're still offering our streaming services. So we're going to stream all of our 11 o'clock service to you in your home, like kind of like we've always been doing, but this one will be live, and so you'll get to participate with us in that way. We know it's not the same as being together, but again, we want to keep as many people safe as possible, and in order for us to do that, we just have to create a couple of guidelines for us to be together well. All that said and done, we know that it's going to feel different. We know that it's going to look different. The sanctuary is set up for social distancing. We know that you're gonna see people you haven't seen in a while. Everything's going to feel just a little bit tilted. But we want to let you know that that's okay. That's okay for things to come in and for you to feel a little bit tilted, because in the end of the day, it's not about the building. It's not about how the chairs are set up. It's not about lights or no lights or cameras or no cameras. It's about the Lord Jesus and his body, the church. So no matter how we come together, the point isn't how, the point is that we're together. I've been reading through the Psalms just in my devotional reading the last couple months, and I came through Psalm 20, and Psalm 20 is just a good, encouraging psalm to end on because it points to the Lord over everything else. And in verse 6 and 7, the psalmist said this, "Now I know that the Lord saves his anointed. He will answer him from his holy heaven with the saving might of his right hand. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord our God." Chariots and horses were big deals back when that psalmist was writing. And we have our own chariots and horses today. And some can trust in chariots and some can trust in horses. Some can trust in buildings and some can trust in other things, but we don't. We trust in the name of the Lord our God over and above everything else. And so we trust the Lord to lead us through this. We trust the Lord to lead us boldly through this. And in doing so, we get together, and that's thrilling. So May 31st, 9 and 11, we'll see you there. We'll send out a link so you can register and show up in a safe, secure, but incredibly exciting way. We'll see you then.